फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज एनजे, यू होस्ट ऑन दिस चैनल. सो वी विल स्टार्ट अवर डिस्कशन ऑन अ वेरी न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट एंड अ वेरी न्यू सेगमेंट ऑफ द लाइंस विच इज वायल एसिविया, एंड दिस कम्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ माइनर लाइंस. यू नो वी द पेस विथ विच वी आर कवरिंग द सिलेबस, आई एम वेरी मच श्योर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू रैप अप द होल सिलेबस इन नेक्स्ट 1.5 मंथ्स. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन द 75% ऑफ द सिलेबस ऑफ द पामिस्ट्री. सो जस्ट बिकॉज गोइंग बाय द फैक्ट दैट दिस टॉपिक इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड अ लॉट ऑफ न्यू पीपल आर गोइंग टू वॉच दिस, सो अ क्विक रिकैप ऑफ द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द पामिस्ट्री. यू नो द होल साइंस ऑफ पामिस्ट्री कैन बी डिवाइडेड इन टू कैटेगरीज. वन इज कीरोग्नोमी, विच इज द स्टडी ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द हैंड. यू नो द शेप ऑफ योर फिंगर्स, द लेंथ ऑफ योर फिंगर्स, द ब्रॉडनेस ऑफ योर पाम टेल्स अ लॉट अबाउट समवन्स इनहेरेंट पर्सनैलिटी. यू नो द बेसिक इंस्टिंक्ट्स इनहेरेंट इन समवन्स पर्सनैलिटी. देन कम्स अनदर वर्टिकल ऑफ द पामिस्ट्री विच इज नोन एज द कीरोमेंसी, विच इज द स्टडी ऑफ द मार्किंग्स ऑफ द लाइन्स ऑफ योर हैंड, विच इज बेसिकली यूज फॉर द फॉर्चून टेलिंग पार्ट. द पास्ट, प्रेजेंट एंड फ्यूचर वी गेट टू नो फ्रॉम द स्टडी ऑफ दिस लाइन. So this is one way to look at it, where the study of the structure of the hand is known as the chirognomy, the study of the lines is known as the chiromancy, and the whole combining these two verticals is known as the chirosophy. Now comes the Hindu palmistry, the Hindu way to look at it, like how we should do the consultation, how should we do the analysis of the hand. So what has been written in the most sacred Hindu scripture devoted to the palmistry, which is known as the Hastamudik Shastra, that we should do the analysis in 3 steps. First step is looking at the hand, darshanam. By looking at the hand, you'll get to know the certain basic traits of the hand, about the structure of the hand. Second is the sparshanam. Sparshanam means you have to touch the hand in order to get to know the basic consistency of the hand, whether the hand is flabby, whether the hand is rigid, whether the hand is soft, as well as the temperature of the hand. And last is rekha vimarshanam, which is the scrutinization of the lines. You know, now comes the part that how these lines marked on our hand gets formed. We have already discussed that the lines get formed on the palm because of the 3 reasons. First is the spiritual, the soul. As it has been believed in spirituality that the soul never dies, it carries the account of the past life deeds. Whatsoever you have done in the past life is going to manifest in the form of these lines, and you'll get the result accordingly. That's the one way of believing it. Second is the genetics, the heredity, the kind of traits a child inherits from his parents. And the third is the fetal environment, the kind of environment which a mother gets at the time of the conception. Now, in our hand, there are 3 major lines which we have already discussed in detail. This is our heart line, which tells about the innermost feelings, the head line, which tells about your intellectual capabilities, and the life line, which tells about your physical health and the stamina. So 3 major lines, these 3 lines. Then we have the secondary lines. Secondary lines are the line of Saturn, which is also known as the line of fate. Then we have line of Sun. And last, we have the line of Mercury, which we have to study. Now comes the part of the minor lines. So, which one amongst those minor lines is the vial acivia? You know, these minor lines tell you a lot about, you know, it helps you in getting a clarity and depth of someone's personality. In the hand analysis, they put a spotlight on natural aptitude and talents, which will help you in forming a personality of someone. You know, when it comes to the analysis, one sign never tells the whole picture. I've been repeatedly saying this thing. A long and straight headline could also make this person a scientist, and this could also make someone a very, you know, sexual or very obsessive stalker. So it all comes down to, you know, judging the hand on other parameters as well. So now comes the part of starting our discussion on the vial acivia. So what does vial acivia mean? You know, a lot of contradictory things have been written in different books by different palmists, as well as over the net also you'll find very different kind of definition of this line. And specifically the most kind of confusing and confusing part is that the name of this concept, lascivia. So in general, what definition has been given to it is that this line, if present on the hand, would make someone very lascivious, you know, very much preoccupied with lustful thoughts, and person would remain too much, you know, kind of susceptible towards temptation, you know, alcohol addiction, drug addiction. So is that true? It's true to an extent, but there is other side of it as well, which we are going to discuss right away, right now. So this is about the introduction part, that the formation of viral ascvia, if spotted on the hand, will tell you about that the person is very much vulnerable towards, you know, temptation, alcohol addiction. So even I have in my own research have found all those people who have with this kind of formation in their hand, have, you know, either they are already addicted to some or other kind of thing, or they have fought, or they are like fighting with all these kind of addictive tendencies in their life. So whether it's in the form of, you know, looking a variety in your relationship, too much of, you know, sexual varieties, person seeking, craving towards sexuality, or this could be craving towards drugs, alcohol, and or other kind of addiction. So then comes the part of the formation of viral ascvia on the hand. So this viral ascvia is found over here. So this is our mount of the moon. This portion is our mount of moon, which is responsible for our imagination, for our thinking, even the restlessness or all the travels are seen from this portion. So any point of time you will find, so you know, in order to judge it, you have to check it in conjunction with the line of Mercury. So the it has been its formation is formed on two levels. One is that this is our line of Mercury, which tells about, you know, your business abilities, and also this line tells a lot about someone's health. Now comes the concept of viral ascvia. So you'll find this line parallel to the line of Mercury somewhere over here. So the thing is, the condition is that this line you will find starting from, because this is our mount of this portion, this whole portion is our mount of moon, which also gets divided in three equal parts. So this portion will be known as the upper mount of moon, this is known as the middle mount of moon, and this will known as the lower mount of moon. So this viral ascvia gets spotted when it starts from the lower mount of the moon and going towards the upper mount of the moon. So that's one way to look at it, that's one formation. And also many palmists have also recognized this kind of formation as the viral ascvia, like this kind of, you know, inverted semicircle is also get seen and labeled as the viral ascvia. So the formation of viral ascvia is of two types. One is when you'll find it in a slanting line parallel to the line of Mercury, let's say like in this formation where line of Mercury is present, there's not an eligibility that this line needs to be present along with the line of Mercury. This line can be spotted independently on the palm as well. So from the lower mount of the moon to upper mount of the moon, this kind of formation is known as a viral ascvia, as well as this kind of inverted semicircle connecting the mount of Venus with the mount of moon is also known as the viral ascvia. This is about the formation of this line on the hand. Next comes the part about whether this line is always evil, whether this line is always bad, or there can also be a good side of it. So like the way I've been telling you people, that whenever it comes to doing the analysis, it is done in conjunction, in combination with other signs present on the hand as well. So let's say for example, if you have spotted this kind of line in the hand, where there are already other kind of afflicted conditions available in the hand. Let's say for example, you have spotted the mount of Venus, which is responsible for your sexual appetite or sexual desires, to be in an afflicted condition. Along with that, the mount of inner Mars is also afflicted, because Mars has got two regions on the palm. This portion is for your aggressive streak, this is for your, you know, mental strength. So let's say for example, the person is already afflicted with a reason or very bad with the presence of negative signs on the mount of the Venus, so which has already aggravated this person's sexual appetite. Along with that, the inner mount of the Mars is also, you know, kind of risen or kind of in a very afflicted and a very intense state. So what is going to happen is that the person has the desire, sexual appetite, and he will have the necessary energy as well to fulfill those desires. And along with that, if the mount of outer Mars is also afflicted, so this is just going to tell that the person is, it's too risen, it's too bulged, curved outside. So this is going to just tell, with the presence of negative signs, so this is going to just tell that the person doesn't have the kind of resistance to put a guard on all of his kind of, you know, negative and evil desires. So what is going to happen is that mount of Venus is afflicted, mount of Mars, plane of Mars is also afflicted. Along with that, the thumb is also clubbed in shape. Like the way I've been repeatedly telling you people, that the thumb is the soul of the hand. You know, this is the only thing which distinguishes us from the primitive humans. So what is going to happen is that if the club is also thumb is also clubbed or bad in shape or short in length, this is going to aggravate the condition because the person's nature would remain to be very animalistic. And along with that, the mount of Jupiter is also afflicted, so the person doesn't have the righteousness and spirituality or kind of, you know, sense of right and wrong while deciding or doing things. Same is headline, which is responsible for your thinking and memory and intelligence, that is also afflicted. Then in with combination with all of these signs and a presence of vile lascivia, then this person would remain to be a sex addict, he could be a drug addict, then we could look at it from that perspective. And along with that, like the way I have been repeatedly saying this thing, the hand gets classified in two ways we can classify the hand. So the first way to look at is that the top flange of our fingers tells about the sattva gun, the mental qualities. Second tells about the practical qualities, and the third flange tells about the physical qualities. This tells about the mental pursuits, this tells about the business qualities, this tells about the indulgences. And the ideal standard length of these phalanges is the of the complete length of the finger. If you'll find this portion to be 20% of the length, then you can say that it is of the standard length. This, if 35% of the length of the whole finger, you can say that it is of standard length. Same way, if this is the 45%, then you can say that this flange is of standard length. But let's say, for example, you will find these bottom flanges to be thick and long, then this could indicate that the person is more, you know, kind of tamas energy driven. That's one way to look at it. Another way of classification of the hand is that this portion tells about the mental sattva guna, this tells about the practical, and this bottom portion tells about the tamas qualities. So sattva, rajas, tamas, mental, practical and physical. So in combination with all of these signs, then that this would aggravate the condition of person taking the path of, you know, addiction. And let's say, for example, if the hand is indicating all the positive qualities, that the thumb is long and firm, and the headline is also unafflicted, mount of Venus is also in a good state, then along with the presence of the line of Mercury, so let's say, for example, the line of Mercury is also present and the vile lascivia is present, then this is going to give the person good result in the form of this is going to act as a sister line to the line of Mercury as well as the lifeline as well. So this will just add to the vitality in someone's personality, in someone's physical constitution. So this is about the good versus bad. Next comes the medical signification of the vile lascivia. You know, what has been found true in the research is that people with this kind of vile lascivia formation, something like this or something like this, people with this kind of vile lascivia formation remain to be, you know, very much kind of sensitive towards different kind of allergies. You know, whether it's kind of allergic to different kind of alcohol, drugs or medication, or remaining, you know, kind of this one disease gone where you have this low blood sugar, hypoglycemia. So even these people remain very much vulnerable towards it. So there is one side of it of vile lascivia where the person has become an addict, and there is one side of it where the person has become very much intolerant and very much allergic towards all these things. So what you'll find, majority of the hands of the people with the presence of vile lascivia, that they would remain to be very much vulnerable towards one or other form of allergies. So this is with the medical signification of this line. And you know, I forgot to tell one thing, that when we were talking about the good versus bad, so the good side of this vile lascivia can also be looked at from that perspective. If it is present in combination with the good signs present on the hand, then the person might, you know, see these kind of you know, proclivities or inclination towards different kind of addictive things as a blessing in disguise, that rather than getting falling prey to all those things, becoming afflicted with all those things, that person might become a doctor or healer by himself and kind of help other people who are going through these kind of, you know, tendencies or problems, to help them to get out of that. So this could be a good side of it. Now next is about discussing the consequences of the vile lascivia. So like the way it always happens in palmistry, that what we have to do is that we have to check. Let's say, for example, you have spotted this kind of vile lascivia in the hand, and you have spotted this vile lascivia to be cutting the cutting the fate line. So this is our fate line. So you have spotted that this is the vile lascivia and it is cutting the fate line. So what is going to happen is that at that particular point of time, wheresoever it has cut it, if the fate line is getting afflicted, so then this could be related and seen and decoded in a way that just because of person's too much of you know physical indulgences that has costed this person's career. So the person's career has taken a toll. That's one way to look at it. Let's say for example, in the wireless severe formation, you have seen that the lifeline is getting afflicted. Then we can look at it from that perspective that because of the too much of the indulgences, the person's health is at radar, person's health is getting a toll. And another way to look at it is, let's say for example, the line of sun is being cut or being afflicted by the wireless severe. Then we can look at it from that perspective that the, just because of too much of, you know, indulgences in alcohol, drug and, you know, multiple relationship, the person's reputation is getting a toll. The person's reputation is getting affected because of that in the society. So this is how analysis is done. I hope I made myself very clear in this video. For further more updates and notification on palmistry, please subscribe my channel and like my Facebook page. Thanks.